talking about development a bit more in detail now, going forward, developing high quality, compliant and individualized and sustainable products with fast innovation cycles require the integration of product development across the entire supply chain. We think that is the true competitive advantage of an ERP-centric PLM strategy. And I guess the new term for that is the digital thread. SAP is in a unique position to help R&D teams to overcome the functional silos and tightly integrate the development function with asset management, with manufacturing, and also with other logistical business processes. The digital thread will enable John and other R&D personas to improve and streamline development processes through collaboration capabilities, but also help them to manage the increasing product complexity and improve the ability to fulfill custom product demand. Talking about product complexity, R&D teams need to leverage a model-based systems approach more and more in the future as products get more complex. The system architecture models we can develop based on SAP Enterprise Product Development often can serve as a foundation to orchestrate the detailed design work from many different engineering disciplines. And therefore, we have evolved SAP Enterprise Product Development to include a model-based systems engineering approach, where R&D teams can detail out product features, analyze the impact of a change, but also work with system engineering partners across business networks. Okay? In the presentation you will receive as a follow-up to this meeting, we have added an additional demo section, right, where you can also check out the latest video we have created for our model-based systems engineering approach. The new enterprise product structure in SAP Enterprise Product Development will make a systems engineering approach even more valuable going forward. And as we are on the way to build out the digital thread, as I indicated earlier, we need to basically have to have a flexible digital product model, and that becomes more relevant than ever. A product model which can evolve over the life cycle of a product itself. And therefore, we are ramping up investments in a brand new product structure management capability under the SAP, under Enterprise Development umbrella. This enterprise product structure will have features to enable R&D teams to handle variants, instances, geometric locations, but also provide insights on installation points. And the overall goal is to use the new enterprise product structure to enable business processes like CTO, CTO Plus, ETO, based on our public stack. I'd like to invite Martin now for a quick demo to show you where we stand as of today with the new enterprise product structure, which we have recently launched in August this year. Over to you, Martin.
Yeah, thanks very much for the introduction. So let me walk you also through a quick demo of this new feature. And as we've seen there, it is quite a product structure is something really, yeah, powerful and really complex. And let me walk you through now what it's looking like. So first of all, we structured everything with folders. So folders is the starting point. Folders helps to organize, to structure the information. So I prepared, of course, my own folder. And now in this short, very short demo, I'd like to give you an insight how to upload the data coming from the S4 system, also from the ECC system. We had this question also earlier in the chat. So there's an add-on, of course, required that prepares these systems. And here, I'd like now to show you how this is really working. So let me import something. So these are the connected backend systems. So it's not only one. Here I've prepared already in the ABAP system some demo data, some skateboard, for example. So you find this demo quite often. System is now asking the backend system, show me everything about the skateboard. And I made free text, and therefore we get quite a lot of data back. So we see already here, oh, it's been synchronized. So I tested it, obviously. And I will synchronize this now and import it also into my folder. Now it's here in my folder. Very nice. So that that was working. And now I can go to the real product structure in EPD. So now the system is loading the product structure application, showing me that there's already more information, like the various plants, various alternatives, and so on. So actually, there is quite some data basically prepared. And I mean, that's yeah, obvious, but so we have quite a lot of data. And I can save that also to my views here. So that is something that is there for all our user interfaces. Just wanted to point it out. Let's go a little bit to the engineering form here now for the skateboard. What I see here is now the structure of the skateboard and the product structure that we are seeing now here in EBD behaves quite similar to the product structure that we know from the other side, but it has also some differences. So if you see here version, for example, you see here unlocked. So there is a couple of details that are different. For example, here if I go to this item, I can go to the product page, and here in the product page I can get an overview on the versions. For example, if there are minor versions, and here's nothing. So that is also, so I can lock this version. I see the data coming from backend. Everything is, of course, customizable. I can also see not only for the items, the information. So here we can get the item. And yeah, we also heard a little earlier, visualization is an important topic, and it really is. So in one of the next releases, for sure, you'll get here also the thumbnails, 3D visualization, all that. Enchilada also there. Yeah. So here now we're on the BOM item level. You can see the attributes, of course, can be configured. We can see the attached documents. In this case, nothing is attached, and so on. If I close it now, here we have also various visualizations for that or representations. So I had the tree structure and the list view. And here with that, I could also navigate between the various levels. So having said that, what you see here is not the overall, the perfect solution. It is the starting point. We start using that, and more upcoming solutions like the handover and like the configuration management and more, you will see also in the future, variant configuration, connection to system, to model-based systems engineering, linked, very closely linked to that. But I wanted to share you the currently available status of this solution, which is already a very good starting point, especially, I think, with the introduction of the new features like versioning, the very tight integration in the downstream systems like the ECC and S4HANA. So, and with that, I would like to hand over to you, Ismail. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Martin. Giving us that as preview basically on what the enterprise product structure is as of today, and maybe also some additional strategic remarks from our side, right? What we want to do in the next releases as we develop the enterprise product structure, right? We said we want to enable a digital product model which is flexible enough and which can evolve over the life cycle of a product. That requires us to also decouple the product structure from an engineering perspective with all the ERP relevant business processes, but at the same time ensure that the enterprise product structure is tightly integrated with the bill of material and the S4HANA side, right? But by decoupling both objects, we can basically move at different speeds, right? We can on the one hand side deliver fast innovations to the R&D personas we talked about, right? And offer new capabilities and features like versioning, the variant management, the integration with configuration management, etc. But at the same time, we keep the bill of material in S4 for all of the downstream processes in manufacturing and the related logistical business processes, right? And this is how we will continue to think about our PLM portfolio, right? We modularize ERP and PLM, but the integration of both worlds will continue to be one of the main success drivers for the new enterprise product structure. Talking about success drivers, we also strongly believe that collaboration capabilities are required to ensure product success. Because when you look into product development, we have many different subject matter experts collaborating with each other. And these subject matter experts are also often work with external partners and suppliers. So this interaction between internal and external people requires a secure and straightforward collaboration platform. And therefore, over the last years, we have been heavily developing a wide variety of collaboration scenarios. And today, for example, you can collaborate across the extended enterprise on bill of materials, on change records, and on specifications, right? We will see that later today, documents, but also connect to other systems where we can basically give you a single source of truth, where you can also create reference objects to other systems, right? So what's happening is that the collaboration is then basically becoming the tool of choice to manage these integration points also with other applications, which will then help us to establish the single source of truth. And another major innovation we have delivered earlier releases is the integration with the Ariba Business Network. That enables, on the one hand side, R&D teams to make more informed buying decisions, but it also supports our procurement organizations as well, right? Because through the insights, everybody will contribute and basically get value out of that. And as you can also see in our product roadmaps, the collaboration capability is packed with a lot of innovations, right? And at this point, I would like to hand over one more time to Carsten, who will walk us through the recent innovations our development team delivered with the 22.8 release.
Okay, thank you. Thank you, Ismail. For collaboration, one of the things which excites me is how close we work with customers. So basically, the entire collaboration engineering team and the product manager team is in constant exchange with customers which are either implementing or using the product live to basically get insights on the usage, positive aspects and items which can be approved or new requirements, and then realize those in really short timeframes and bring them on the roadmap. So in collaboration, we started with collaboration on documents. We added then the integration with visualization and then added bill of materials to collaborate also on product data. Now we have taken this integration to the next level and are able to collaborate on not only a single bill of material. We can define so-called product data package, which is basically any number of bill of materials and hierarchies which you want to share with a supplier. This also is going to integrate with S4, so that you can define those packages on the S4 side, bring them to EPD, to the collaboration, fine-tune them in the collaboration, share them with the suppliers, including the links to the documents. So it means you have the product data linked to the documents, that the context is kept between the documents and the product data, and can share those with the suppliers. The supplier can download those. As example, we support the PBX format, which is used, as example, in the high-tech industry quite commonly. We also support CSV or simple download formats, like in a CSV file. However, we don't stop there. We also allow basically the supplier to make changes or the redlining on the cloud side, on the cloud version. And then we are able to compare basically what was changed. We integrate with different version change numbers from the S4 side and can compare, push new versions to the supplier, get his feedback. And in the future, the direction will go also that after we validated the feedback and after an approval process, we'll be able to take changes back into the ERP or S4 system. So this was a journey. It's a larger development. And we have achieved here really good progress. One item which basically was feedback directly from customers to improve the collaboration was how to work with workflows. In collaboration, we really use a workflow to drive the business process. So not only to dump basically documents and product data to the participants of the collaboration, but also to drive this process through workflow, so that each party knows what he or she needs to do, what needs to be approved, and which data belong to this workflow step. However, the workflow steps were handled in a separate application. And now we have combined this from a user experience that it's all part of the collaboration and much more accessible. We also improved the user experience. So we see EPD as a suite. That means different capabilities should look similar. So we improved the status overview, a collaboration goes through a lifecycle. And we made this now generic across EPD that we have a nice visual representation of where in the lifecycle basically the collaboration is. Then we also looked into office tools, what features they provide. And instead of only sharing a link to a collaboration, we are now able to share deep links to individual files or folders of the collaboration to basically send to an email or to a third party to share those. And last but not least, we started with a new integration in EPD collaboration, with an integration to the change record. Typically, when you do a product change on the S4 side, as example, as part of the manufacturing process, very often you have to extend this product change to suppliers. And then, of course, it would be handy if the change record goes hand to hand with the collaboration. And this integration we have enabled. We are now the link between the change record and the collaboration, and we will extend this to share business data between the objects to basically make product changes a seamless experience for users inside the organization as well as with extended enterprise. So those are the new features which came in 22.8. Basically, we shipped this release around two weeks ago. And I will continue to develop this integration with change record with this process. We will continue with the product data exchange to make this bidirectional, and of course, work closely with customers to take their feedback into account. So that's it. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Carsten, for providing the update on what's new in collaboration with our last release. So let's look a bit ahead. And I think if you look at our roadmap for R&D roles in the develop area, we have some really exciting new innovations in the pipeline for R&D teams. While the new configuration management capability, which Martin briefly mentioned, will enable baselining of product structures, we are also working on a new CAD integration capability as part of our SAP Enterprise Product Development or product strategy. This new CAD integration will strengthen our direct CAD integration approach with SAP S/4HANA Cloud. And we will use also the next webinar on SAP Enterprise Product Development to provide a little bit more color on these new capabilities on the one hand side for the config management, but also where we will talk about the CAD integration strategy we have for the public cloud. And for formulation-driven product development processes, I think we're also about to launch one very exciting new capability in our November release, where we will enable our process industry customers to manage specifications. And we will talk about that in the November event a bit more in detail. And this new specification management capability, which we are launching towards the end of this year, will then be also the foundation for us to release a next generation recipe formulation solution in 2024.